In today's video, I'm going to be talking about circular polarizers and why this is a must-have addition to your camera gear, so stay tuned. Hey, what's up everyone? It's Dennis here, back with another video. For those of you who are new here, my channel is all about drone, product reviews, and tutorial videos. So if that's something that you're interested in, do subscribe to my channel and turn on that notification button so that you don't miss out on any of my new videos every week. Now that's out of the way, let's get started. So you got yourself a camera along with a couple of lenses, and you may have heard people talking about a circular polarizing filter or CPL, and you're not sure what this is about. You may have seen some of your favorite photographers showcasing their landscape photos. You might be wondering, how did they capture that particular shot with those vivid colors? Chances are they're probably using a circular polarizing filter or CPL. Before I show you how a circular polarizing filter works, let me give you some information on what this is about and why photographers and videographers love this. A circular polarizer or polarizers block scattered light from entering your camera, therefore reducing haze in your photos and increasing color saturation. If you have a polarizing filter, it can turn that sky from blue to more blue. Also, polarizers cut off reflections from water and metallic surfaces, giving plants and rocks increased clarity and color saturation. As awesome and as useful the CPL is, please don't fall into trap thinking that you need to use the CPL every time you go out and shoot. You need to know when and how to use it, as it has its own sort of unique quirkiness, if you might say. It's critical to understand that a polarizer works best when you're pointed 90 degrees away from the sun, okay? Please note that circular polarizers doesn't work at all if you are pointing your camera directly to the sun or directly away from the sun. Very important that you know this, because this could be one of the reasons why the circular polarizer that you're using might not be doing anything at all. Give you an example. Let's say you're shooting directly into the sun. You're probably gonna see there's no effect on the circular polarizer that you're using, or you may see one part of your shot a little bit more saturated than the other. Or in short, I'd say there's gonna be an even tone or color tone into the sky or to the subject that you're looking at. One of the nice things about the circular polarizer is that it's not like an all or nothing filter, like for example like an ND filter. You can actually turn and adjust how strong you want the effect to be. For example, if you want your skies to be super dark, then all you need to do is really just twist, you know, to the maximum polarization, or you can dial back a little bit just so that you can control and see what the effect's gonna look like. Another key thing about the polarizer is that it actually limits the amount of light coming in, kind of similar to the ND filter. So most polarizers, when they're actually under a maximum or strongest effect, it actually limits or decreases, you know, up to about 2 stops of light. So you should really bear in mind and actually think of when or how you're gonna use the polarizer as it fits your artistic intention. Overall, a circular polarizer will definitely level up your photography and videography game. As I mentioned earlier, if you've seen some of your favorite photographers with their landscape shots or amazing videos that they come up with, chances are they're actually using a circular polarizers to boost up the saturation and reduce, you know, reflection and the haze on the image that they're taking. Overall, circular polarizer is a fantastic filter to have in your camera gear. Now that you know more about them, you can definitely put them to good use. Also, I'll link down some of my favorite circular polarizing filters down below. Do check them out. As always, thank you for watching. And if you enjoyed this video, remember to give it a like, really appreciate it, and subscribe to my channel for more videos. Oh, by the way, do follow me on my other social media accounts, Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, and more for new updates and exclusive content. Well, that's about it. This is Dennis, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye. I just want to quickly show you how to put a circular polarizer. I've got a Sohya circular polarizer here with a 7.7 millimeter size, and I've got my Sigma lens in here, the 1750, and then all you need to do is just pretty much screw them on, similar to like any UV filter that you can put in.